Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. A lot of you have asked for an updated sewing room tour, so that's what we're gonna do today. So here's kind of the view from my sewing room. It's right by our front door. And then I've got these nice big double doors so I can see out into the house, which makes me feel kind of included. So this is the view from my doors. I've got double doors into this office, and so it's just nice and wide and open in here. And I really like that it's nice and bright. I've got those big windows on the side, so I get a lot of nice natural light, but it's actually a covered patio or a front porch, so I don't get any direct sunlight hitting any of my fabric, so I don't have any fading issues or anything like that. So behind my door, I also have these IKEA pegboards. They're super handy, but I will let you know that the only pegs that fit into them are the ones from IKEA. They aren't like a regular pegboard. The holes are kind of oblong. So down here on the bottom, I have all of my zippers, and they're all kind of in rainbow order, and they're just hanging on these little pegs. I've got my little mini Oliso, a couple of other fun doodads, and then moving up, I have all of my kind of smaller rulers. I like having them this way because I can see them and they're super easy to grab and use, so very functional. And then up here on top is one of my favorite features, and I saw this on Pinterest or somewhere and I thought, what a fun way to put your kind of used balls of yarn. They're really easy to see, easy to take off and put back, and plus it's kind of like a little piece of art right here in my sewing room. And so I just used these little pegs that came from IKEA, put them all over my wall randomly. Some are on pegs, some are just kind of shoved in there, and so I've just added to them as I've used yarn, and if I need it, I can just take it right off the wall and use it. So that's really fun, and I just love looking at that because it's kind of like a pretty little art statement, but it's also super functional. Next to that, I have my new desk set up. I like that it's right here in front of a window. I can see outside. It also allows me to see my monitor so I can watch movies while I'm sewing. I also got a new chair this year. This is off Amazon, so I will link that below. I like that it's rolly and it's white and squishy. And then of course, here's my computer in my desk drawers. They're kind of messy right now, but I just have some of my just little doodads and things that I need. I've got electrical stuff over here. And then this one is probably kind of a mess because I've got some secret sewing in here. I've got all my weird shaped rulers that I don't use very often and I don't know what to do with. And then up here on my windowsill, I have all of my flosses. I've got my labels. These are really cool. These are Kimberbell, and they are kind of like slap bracelets, but they're meant to be used around, she has a bunch of different kind of interfacing and things like that. And so I thought they were really cute, and I'll show you how I use those here in just a minute. I've got some poppy cotton fabric to show you in my next podcast. This is actually my white scrap bin, and if you've ever seen any of my videos, you know that Jax lays in here, so I actually had to put a towel in here to cover up my fabric and keep it white because he will not stay out of this basket. We also have a cute little bin here. These are random kind of orphan blocks that were from other projects, and I just didn't know what to do with them, and so I'm just keeping them all in here, and maybe one day I will, I don't know, do something fun with them. I've got some Wonder Clips there, and then I've got this cute little metal mug that's a Lori Holt Riley Blake mug, and I think I got it in one of my boxes, and it has all of my pens, pencils, and point turners and things like that in there. And then if we back up, we are at my sewing table here. So I love this tabletop, and I do have some other videos on it, but basically it's two IKEA tabletops put together. So I think the total is about 47 this way, and then I think it's about 76 this way. My room is about 13 by 14, so if that gives you any kind of an idea of how much space I have in here with that tabletop. And then I just used these legs here in the center, and those are actually screwed up into both tabletops to hold them together, and so they don't come apart or slide around or anything like that, and it actually works really well. Plus then I have a really nice big surface to quilt on, sew on, cut on, and whatever else I need. Underneath my table right here are my scrap bins, and I need to get one more wooden bin to go right here, but I haven't fully decided if I'm going to keep them there yet, so that's just where they are for right now. But I would like to get one more just so that I have a little bit more room. This side is all my Christmas fabrics, and they are bursting at the seams. This side is all my regular fabrics, and this is the one I just reorganized in a video that I did here on YouTube. Moving around to my sewing machine, I've got my Juki TL2000QI. I love this machine. I will link it below. And it's sitting on top of my big matte rotary cutting surface, which I also love. It almost covers my entire table. It's got nice clear marks on it, and it just makes it easy for me to use my entire space. And then over here on the side of my machine, I just have a little caddy that I keep some of my commonly used supplies in. My thread catcher right there that I use all the time. And then up here on my window, I've got another caddy. I have a ton of these little sew-in stashes from Fat Quarter Shop. I think I got them in my sew sampler box. And so I've got a cup with my rotary trimmers in here and some scissors. This is my machine oil, my quarter inch tape, and then I've got cleaning supplies, seam rippers, scissors. These are all of my little alpha bitties, which I use all the time, so I like to keep those handy, and I just have them in these little jars. I think I got these at IKEA. I've got some pins and things like that in this tin, my sewing machine tools and feet in here, and then this is some embroidery stuff, and these tins I all got at Fat Quarter Shop. So moving up from that window, I've got my big storage area up here. Along that top, I've got some glass jars that have some scraps in them. I've got my Clara Singer Featherweight Sewing Machine, and then I've got all of my main fabric stored in those white bins. Those are from Target. They're about, I think, $5 or $6 each. And then in the bottom of this, I have all of my spinning fiber, which I have a ton of, so I really need to get started spinning. But I do have to keep these in these bins, so otherwise Jax will get into them and just tear into my fiber. He cannot resist the fiber. And then this last one down here, I've got my batting. And this one is super full because I use batting all the time in my smaller projects. My main roll of batting is downstairs in my basement, but I keep this for all of my bags and things like that. So on this top shelf, I've got all of, I think this is almost all Bonnie and Camille. And I just have those still, I haven't gotten any more bins. So those are all just still kind of stacked up. So I love these bins because they keep everything nice and organized. These are all of my layer cakes, and I actually just have them rolled up just like that. It makes it really nice and easy. I can pull one out. I can kind of see all the fabric, so that's really fun. This one has mostly Lori Holt. This one has Sweetwater, but you can really just take one of these bins, pull the entire bin out to your table, work on it, put whatever scraps or anything you have left back in here, put the bin back, and it's super fast and easy, and it's a really nice way to keep all of my fabric nice and clean and organized. Then next to my main storage, I've got my quilt wall. I always have a different quilt hanging up on my wall because I love it. I also have my quilt ladder there, which I love. And down here, I have my spinning wheel, and there's another bowl for Jax to lay in, which he does. He likes to just kind of roam around and lay in different bowls throughout my sewing room. I also on this wall have my thread, and this is just one of those wooden thread spool keeper thingies. And I just put it on my wall using those Velcro command strips. So that's awesome. Above there, I've got my YouTube play button. Thank you guys so much for subscribing to my channel. I do like to keep it displayed. It kind of is a reminder that you guys are out there supporting me and encouraging me, and so I just love that. There's a little mini there, and here's my August Truck of the Month block, which you can get on my website. It's almost time for the September one, so I'm super excited. Then I have my design wall up here, and some of that's a little bit of a sneaky peek, so I'm trying to cover it up. And then below my design wall, I've got my yardage fabric and my pressing station. So this is actually one of my favorite stations. I do have a tutorial on how to make that ironing board. It's super easy, and it's really just a piece of wood that I covered with batting and some fabric, stapled it to the other side, so it's not super pretty, but it works out really well, and it fits exactly on top of my IKEA bookshelf, which holds all of my yardage for my backings and other large projects. And then, of course, down here on my floor, I have my Jelly Roll rug, which I made a while ago. That's a video tutorial, and I love it, and it's holding up well, and it's also kind of where Bandit lays while I'm sewing. Then next to my pressing station is this four-piece cubicle from IKEA that holds my quilt patterns. I've got some works in progress in there. I've got things like 505 basting spray and just, you know, some of my planners and books and things like that. Then if we look on top of my shelves, I have this really cute little wooden storage bin. This is from IKEA. And I just have all of my little specialty fibers in here. So there's gonna be some crinkling, sorry. But just really fun, like little stellina and bits of sari silk and things like that. So that's what's in this whole thing. And it just makes it really easy to keep these kind of hidden away and safe. And then I can just pull out those drawers and use them. I also have three full bobbins that I need to unwind. These two are finished. This one still needs to be plied. I've got a cute little clock from IKEA, and then I have my Brother Drum Carter, which I absolutely love, and I've been having so much fun carding my own fiber. These are all of my own hand-carded creations, and so it's just a lot of fun to make my own yarn from the ground up. And then if you move over to the right here, I've got a little can and trash can, actually, but it's holding all of my kind of larger interfacings and things like that. And as you can see, I'm using those little slap bracelets to kind of keep them together. Now, the slap bracelets are actually pre-marked with all of her stuff. She has a bunch of different kind of interfacing. For example, this one says fusible something, fusible backing. I don't know. It's actually holding my vinyl, so I don't care what it says. It's just holding my pieces in place, and so I'm using it for that, and they're actually just stacked in this little bin right here. Probably could do something better, but for right now, that's working. And then right next to them, I've got some of my fusible batting, and then that's some sew-in foam, and so that's just kind of behind my door, so I don't have to see it. I've also got my Cricut loom right there, and this is where I have kind of my yarn stash. So this is actually behind my door. You can't really see it unless you close my door. Those are all the skeins of yarn from independent dyers that I have collected over the years, and there's a little cake block up on top. I also have this really cute wreath on my door that I made in a tutorial on YouTube as well. And that's just kind of a fun little decor, and I always have that door open so I can see it. But here is what my room looks like, kind of in a nutshell. All right, guys, that is it. I'm super pleased with how my sewing room turned out. It's nice and clean, and I think it's gonna be really functional. I also really like going through my sewing stuff because I find things that I forgot I had. Sometimes I have whips that I've stashed away and I forgot about. So it just kind of gives me some new inspiration and encourages me to work on more projects. So that's gonna be it for today's video. If you liked it, please make sure to thumbs up and subscribe. That way I know to keep making them for you. Thanks for joining me today, and I will see you next time. Hang on, I just have to do my outro.